Well, we can now go back to our top story, the withdrawal of heavy weaponry in Ukraine. And we can get the first-hand update, in fact, from Alexander Hook, who's deputy chief monitor of the OSCE mission in Ukraine. Thank you so much, Mr. Hook, for joining us here on RT International. Well, the OSCE spokesman earlier said today that not everyone has provided the necessary information about the withdrawal to the monitors. Now, can you please clarify who the parties at fault are?
Well, thank you very much. I would like first to say that today we have to commend both sides that they have now done something that has not been done before. We see now mutual actions towards compliance with the Minsk arrangements. The OSCE Special Monitoring Mission notes that both sides have announced that they will be moving hardware away from the front line. This afternoon, the government of Ukraine has done that as well. We welcome this mutual step now from both sides to start walking towards adherence to
Okay, but we also know that in the East Ukraine, the Eastern Ukrainian side also has pulled out almost 90% of their heavy weaponry. So what's going on?
Well, you know, it is up to the OSCE Special Monitoring Mission to verify the withdrawal. It's the only organization that has been tasked to do so. It is not up to the sites to declare. It is not up to the media to assume. It is up to the OSCE Special Monitoring Mission to verify actual withdrawal. And we do so carefully. And we will do so when we'll be able to say so. Once and remain withdrawn, we will state so publicly.
Okay, well, you said that your mission is to verify, the mission of the OSCE, in fact. But the OSCE has also said that in order to verify the withdrawal by anti-government forces, they have to know where the armor is being taken to. But, you know, given that the authorities in East Ukraine have publicly named all the locations, what seems to be the problem there?
The OSCE Special Monitoring Mission requires a series of key baseline information that is not only the starting point where the hardware is located now, it also requires the routes and, most importantly, the storage places where the hardware will be stored at the end. We are getting closer to towards receiving this information, which is sensitive information, of course, and we will not make it, therefore, also public in terms of the exact locations. What we will be able to say once we are in a position to do so is whether or not weapons have, in actual fact, been withdrawn.
But, you know, the OSCE monitors are on the ground. Why didn't, you know, some of them go, in fact, to those locations 2 days ago when everything was more or less known and clear? Why wasn't that opportunity taken advantage of?
Well, I have to make reference to our daily reports where we clearly have noted the movement of military hardware within the area that you have made now just reference to. But again, it's a big difference between attesting to compliance with the Minsk arrangement and the simple monitoring of movement of hardware. If you read our public reports, you can see the clear reference to such movements, which we think is a positive step in the right direction. Now this will be followed up further. We are in contact with both parties, and we are confident that we walk on the right way now, and that the parties will be able to withdraw these guns, these artillery devices, which have caused so much havoc in the past.
But why, I mean, just once again, just want to reiterate the question that I asked earlier, but why didn't the monitors, in fact, go there earlier?
The monitors have always been in the area. We have always been monitoring, but monitoring the area is something different than verifying the actual withdrawal. And verifying the withdrawal is telling the truth about the fact to which both sides have agreed to in Minsk the last time, we reiterated on the 12th
of
February.
Yeah, but Mr. Hook, you keep saying that the monitors are monitoring the withdrawal, but monitoring and verifying are two different things. So why is it they're not monitoring to verify that it is indeed taking place, and specifically what is going on there?
I repeat again, what we need to know is the details of the actual withdrawal plans from both sides. Once we received it in details, and we have met step forwards today, we have had out over 20 patrols this afternoon who were accompanying some of these plans that have been submitted to us. And we will report so publicly later on today. And that will then also highlight to the general public what we have been observing.
Well, you mentioned earlier the Minsk agreements, and I'd like to elaborate on this now here. And the Minsk agreements clearly state that the OSCE mission is to make sure that there's no heavy artillery in the so-called buffer zone, something your monitors can easily do, of course. Why then is the OSCE putting forward additional demands?
Well, let me do a thing very clear here. It is not up to the OSCE to remove these weapons. It's up to the sites to remove these weapons. It is up to us to monitor the situation and to verify that the parties have done that. We are not putting up demands. The demands are clear, and it's the demand to the site to withdraw their weapons. What we are tasked by the Minsk arrangement and by our mandate is to go out there and monitor what the parties do, and we report so publicly.
Well, we also know that the Ukrainian army has today, in fact, said that it started withdrawing its heavy artillery, which is 2 days after the Eastern Republic started doing so. So how do you assess that? How fair is that, in other words?
Well, we welcome this step today. It is important that both parties mutually now undertake steps to walk along that agreement to which they have agreed. We welcome that both sides are now indicating that they're taking steps to comply with these responsibilities. And once they have fully complied with all the measures, not just with the ceasefire and the withdrawal, but with all the other 11 points that the Minsk arrangements lay out, we will then be able to attest to that fact.
Right, Alexander Hug, Deputy Chief Monitor of the OSCE mission in Ukraine. Thanks for talking to us and giving us your take on the situation.